Hi, I'm Ann Delisi. Detroit jazz bassist Rob Crozier has a new CD out titled Ocean Blue, with performances next week, February 6th through the 9th, at the Dirty Dog Jazz Cafe. Although now an accomplished bassist, his parents introduced him to percussion first.
My two older sisters and I, we were all encouraged to play rhythm. And so we were all given classes in rhythm on the paradiddle pad and all that. That really stuck with everybody. For me, it kind of took the shape of me being really into African percussion and hand percussion. So that's something that I also do. And I believe this to be true. Some people philosophize that every instrument is in essence a drum because, you know, music is so rhythmic. That's what makes everything hold together. It was really that for me, you know, that kind of natural extension of the pulse that I had been developing, you know, my whole life. And it really was an extension of that sort of hand drumming experience. And then certainly I had like listened to a lot of music that I had referenced to, you know, figure out how to make it all, you know, kind of come together. Bass didn't really come until later, and it was a sort of classic situation of, you know, we've got too many guitars, so we need bass. That's how it all, you know, that half the time that's what happens, right?
And you got really serious about it because then you studied at University of Michigan.
Yes, I did. And then through that experience, studied with Bob Hurst, internationally renowned bass player and like on the top of the heap in the jazz community for sure.
Yep. What was the biggest thing he taught you?
To always bring your imagination to what you're doing with your instrument and with your music, to really bring your own personal experience to what you're doing. Nobody can be better at you than you. An influence on me musically, but also from the standpoint of taking risks and just taking a chance to say something unique. That's what I learned from him.
Rob Crozier began incorporating instruments and music from other cultures, including the didgeridoo that was created by the Aboriginal people of Australia. Here's how that instrument made its way into Rob's music.
My sister and brother-in-law got the idea to get me a didgeridoo, and it was a really cool didgeridoo made out of clay, and I still have it. I protected it. It's in the corner at home.
And what are they typically made of?
And they're typically made out of the shaft of a cactus that is hollowed out with termites in the middle, and then it would eat through the middle of it and soften up all the stuff. And then they would take this steel rod or some kind of a device and run through the middle of it to hollow it out, and then put a little mouthpiece of like beeswax or something on it, and then you're off and running.
What were the challenges of learning to play the didgeridoo?
You know, honestly, I wish I could say that there was like this sort of great story about how hard it was and that I ran up against obstacles, but honestly, it took me about 20 minutes to like learn how to circular breathe.
All of his music and life experiences have come together with a new CD titled Ocean Blue.
The CD is in tribute to the nature all around us, and I have pieces that I've written about the Great Lakes, Holmes, which is H-O-M-E-S, you know, the letter for each of the Great Lakes. The CD is a real interesting mix of world music and jazz. There's some contemporary swing tunes that, you know, sound like jazz, and then there's some other tunes that are really strongly world music, Afrobeat, whatever you want to call it.
Rob Crozier brings his variety of jazz styles to the Dirty Dog Jazz Cafe in Grosse Pointe, February 6th through the 9th. For info, visit dirtydogjazz.com. To find out more about Rob Crozier's music, go to robcroziermusic.com. For WDET, I'm Ann Delisi.